Hello students, so in last lecture we studied some genetic terminologies like the trait, cross, what is the homozygote, what is the heterozygote, what is the gene. Okay, in this video we will see the remaining terms which are important for the genetics. Okay, so the next one is the phenotype. What is the phenotype here? The phenotype is the observable characteristics of an organism. Okay, what is the meaning of the observable characteristics of an organism? Here I will tell you the example of the phenotype. That means you can see any flower is a red in color. Okay, you can see the height of the plant, that plant is tall or either dark. Okay, or simply you can see the shape of the seed. Okay, that is round one or that is wrinkled one. That is called a phenotype of that individual or the organism. Okay, that is called a phenotype. Here, the red color flower. Okay, so that is the best example for to understand that what is the phenotype. That means, simply phenotype is what? The characters which you can see with your eyes. Okay, that is called the phenotype. Next to the phenotype, there is the genotype. Okay, so if you are studying the genetics, you should know that what is the genotype. Okay, genotype is the genetic makeup of a particular type of the organism. Okay, what is the genetic makeup of an organism? Here again, I will tell you example of the red flower. Okay, red colored flower is there. That means this is the phenotype is there. But what is the genetic makeup of that red flower? That is called the genotype. Okay, if you see the genotype of the red flower, you will obviously write the capital R, capital R. Okay, because the genetic makeup of the red colored flower is the capital R, capital R. So that's why that is called the genotype of the red colored flower. Okay, I hope you understand both the terms phenotype and the genotype. Next to the phenotype and the genotypes, there is the next term which is called the hybrid. Okay, what is the hybrid now? The hybrids are the offsprings of the two different type of the organism or the two different parents. If the two different type of the parents are making cross between them for any particular purpose, that time whatever the offsprings we got from that different type of the parents, these offsprings are called the hybrids. Okay, so that is the hybrid. Next to the hybrid, there is the carrier. Okay, carrier means what? Something is transferring from one generation to the another generation. That is the different thing. Okay, but carrier is what? Actually, you know that dominant and the recessive, these are the two different terms which are important in the genetics. So, what happened in the dominant and the recessive character? The dominant character expressed in the first filial generation. That means, something is carrier. Why? Because the recessive characters are expressed in the second filial generation. Okay, so how will you define the carrier? An individual. But not, they are not in the pure form. What you call the homozygous. They are not the homozygous. Okay, so an individual heterozygous, the individual, but they are the heterozygous with the recessive gene. These are called the carrier. That means when they will express in the first filial generation, they will not show their recessive trait or the recessive character. Okay, when that carrier will continue in the second filial generation, that time they will express their recessive character, that is called as the carrier. Okay, now whatever I was telling you, that first filial generation, second filial generation, that terms are here now. Okay, so the P1 generation, parental generation. Okay, P1, that P stands for the parents. So the P1 generation is the parental generation, which the meaning the organisms which are involved in the original cross. That means first time whatever you are taking for the cross, that is called the P1 generation. Next to the P1 generation, again the important term is the F1 generation, which is also known as the first filial generation. And what is that first filial generation? First filial generation means the offsprings of the two genetically different parents. Okay, the offsprings which are got in the after the parental generation, there is a first filial generation. And what is the F2 generation, which is also known as the second filial generation? The second filial generation, the offsprings of the F1 breeding. Okay, actually what the Mendel did, first the parental generation, okay, then he got the first filial generation. Okay, so for the more experiments he want to do, that's why he did the F1 breeding. That means whatever the offsprings got in the first filial generation, the self crossing done between the F1 generation, that is called the F1 breeding. Okay, and from that F1 breeding, whatever the offsprings or the whatever the results got to the Mendel, okay, that is called the second filial generation. Okay, so these are some important terms which are always used in the genetics. Okay.